anime pacing, episode count, original content within the Bleach anime itself, and you watch his beard, as well as a bit of Disney talk as well. Stick around, because in this video, we're going to be talking about those. Let's get into it. Since we talked about Disney in our last video, there was a lot of concerns about sources, about validity, as well as the concerns about Disney overall. Mainly, really alluding around censorship, which I believe there wouldn't be, because obviously Kubo has already said that it is going to be uncensored. So if the licensors want to censor it, then just know that when you buy the home video release in general, it will be uncensored. But regardless of what, it's a possibility. I hope it doesn't happen. I hope Crunchyroll kind of gets it, but that ultimately doesn't stop Disney from getting their hands on it for the Japanese release anyway. But when it comes to things like that, those are things that are happening behind the scenes, so things that you won't really initially see or know of. So in today's video, I kind of want to delve a little bit into things that will become more tangible later on down the road, something that you will actually see. And I will try and be a little bit careful on what I say here, but nonetheless, I'm going to give you some anime info. Now, of course, let's talk about anime pacing and where things will go. So as you may or may not have known, Bleach is going to be a long-running series, meaning it's going to be confirmed a four-core series. So that means anything from 50 to 51 episodes. That will probably give or take go maybe over the year a little bit, but when you consider Japanese holidays and whatnot, there is going to be some episodes that aren't going to air in that year. So it's probably going to go just over the year if we go by the four-core logic. Now, from what I've been told and what I actually know and things that you will actually see, and you can come back to this video when it actually happens, is that each episode is going to be four chapters an episode. Now, to some people, that may be quite fast, and by golly, it is. It's very fast. But you've got to take into consideration the majority of the Thousand Year Blood War arc is a lot of fighting and not much dialogue. The dialogue generally comes after those big first invasions and even towards the end when, you know, when it was like Ichigo versus Uatch and like Ukitake and Kisuke are doing the whole, you know, getting things to get spiritual pressure to make the gate and whatnot. So there's like, there is a lot of talking in some parts of the arc, but for the majority of the part, it is fight after fight after fight after fight, which is really cool. So having those four chapters an episode in hindsight isn't that bad, but what the positive thing is and what I can tell you is a lot of these fights are actually going to be stretched out because a lot of the animators have a lot of creativity with the fights as well. So it's really interesting to me that they're doing four chapters per episode, because in saying that, it actually seems to be the case that you might actually see the Bleach anime as a whole go past the four core thing, but at the moment it is a placeholder for four cores, because if you look at the 206 chapters being converted into four chapters per episode, you're actually looking at about 51.5 episodes, which obviously some chapters are going to fluctuate in between themselves. I would imagine that the first episode is going to be around about five chapters, maybe even six. I'm not quite sure. I only know some information on some of the episodes, but from those episodes, you're looking around about, for the majority, the average is about four chapters an episode, which is fine, because also as well, which is interesting to me and why I think it's going to go over the original four core mark, is because of Kubo adding more content into the anime, as we know. And we can only tell as far as the planning stage is at the moment and what's been animated currently at the moment. And I would say that the start of the Thousand Year Blood War arc is kind of strong in and of itself, and there's not really much to add and there's not really much to change, because, you know, Kubo's health deteriorated more towards the second half of the series, and that's where things started to get rushed rather than the first part of the arc. So I wouldn't imagine there's going to be too much changes other than maybe like foreshadowings or extended scenes. And the last we heard from Kubo is that the last thing he was working on was in regards to the Unohana and Kenpachi fight, which is quite a bit down the road a little bit, admittedly. But even more so, as the recording of this video, Kubo has once again stated that he is still involved and he's still creating more in canon stuff or more original content, whatever original truly means. So with the four chapter mark that we have currently, plus the original content being thrown in, it's seeming to me we're going to get really over a year of Bleach, which is fantastic. But as I said, that's all speculation. But ultimately, we're going to use the four chapters an episode and the four core thing as a, like a baseline to get an idea of how much content we're going to be getting. I think we're going to get more, but I think that this is a placeholder. But from the episodes I know that have been worked on, it's definitely four chapters for those episodes and seems like it's going to be the average. Now, am I concerned about the pacing of that? Not really. I do think that initially when you first think about how fast that is, like four chapters an episode, you got to fundamentally think about the manga and how much stuff is going on, like the fights and the action. But give and take, some of the animators are actually having a lot of creativity with the fights. I've got a lot of hope and a lot of excitement for it, and you definitely won't get bored, especially when we're competing competing with a lot of other shows within the full season. I feel like we're going to get a lot of Sakuga moments, a lot of high animation that is just going to really blow people's socks off. So I would rather fast pacing than actual slow pacing. And in this regards, where the fights are majority fights in the Thousand Year Blood War arc, is it really classed as fast pacing? I'm not quite sure. I would class it more so as normal pacing, if anything. Because if you look at the manga, a lot of the fights are actually very quick and very, like, impactful. So the fact that they're putting in four chapters in an episode is actually quite slow, not slow paced, but maybe more normal paced in comparison to the fast paced. So don't let the number of chapters divert you away from the worry and the concerns that you may think that the series is going to end quicker than originally planned. Because again, we have a four core placeholder. So that's really good in and of itself. Again, unlike Unohana, Kubo didn't specifically say where in the manga or where in the anime they are at the moment, so we're gonna have to kind of assume right after the Unohana versus Kenpachi fight, which is where things start settling down and where things like Shunsui's kind of talking to Aizen about getting him involved and whatnot, so it's probably a lot of prep, or the maybe just starting the second act of the Thousand Year Blood War arc is maybe my guess, which is cool in and of itself that Kubo has the time to do that. I also want to talk about Yuwachi's beard, because if you hadn't read the manga back in the day, like on a weekly basis, there was a bit of a theory that as Yuwachi was getting stronger and was obtaining his true form, so to say, we kind of noticed this progression through his beard. And I think Kubo was kind of dabbling on what kind of style to go for throughout the series. What I've been told and what the character design sheets from what I've seen is the case is that Yuwachi is going to have his bushy beard from the very get-go. Again, something else that you will see when it comes out, maybe when a TV comes out, or maybe when the episode drops, that's something that's going to be more validable to you, so you can say sources, he's got none. Well, you know, there you go, there's something that you can actually see for yourself when it happens. So yes, you watch his beard is in full bushiness, which is a little bit of a change to the manga. And as well, if you want to have a good grasp, because a lot of people are gassing up the PV, which you should, I think the PV is good. The first part and the last bit of the PV is what really matters to me. But like the stuff in between is just like, you know, just padding out just for the PV's sake. But if you want a good grasp on what the anime is going to be looking like, or what kind of model or character design it's really going to look like the most, is if you look at every, maybe not every Yuwachi, I'm not really specific on what part of Yuwachi, but the Yuwachi scenes or Yuha box scenes in the PV is the ones of what it's going to look the closest to the anime. Like, that's the closest representation. So if you like those shots of Yuha box, then good for you, because that's the closest it's going to be looking like. So, and I'm not against that. I think that's really fantastic. But to talk about the PV as well, we need to also talk about the Getsuga Tensho as well, because it was the Galaxy Purple Getsuga Tensho that people really liked, or they were like, really like, oh, I kind of wanted my black and red one like they did in the old anime, which is fine, because again, you are going to be getting that. The Getsuga Tensho is not going to be changing its color. And I did leak this on Twitter not long ago because I didn't really think it was video worthy. And I kind of understand people's concerns, like the purple does look really cool, but at the same time, the purple Getsuga is something that should be happening at the towards the end of the series when Ichigo gets his kind of true Shikai and true Bankai, right? Because then again, how are you gonna have like the Getsuga Jujisho, which is definitely like two different Getsugas, and in the illustrations of the manga, one's a black Getsuga and one's a blue or white Getsuga, whatever you want to really classify is in the manga, because it's obviously black and white. So, but the point is, you can't differentiate the two Getsugas if they're both purple, not signifying the Quincy one and not signifying the hollow one, so say hollow slash Shinigami, whatever, doesn't matter. So you're not going to get rid of the purple Getsuga. It's probably going to happen later on. We don't know yet because we're not that far into animating those bits of the true Shikai slash Bankai. We're at the beginning stages. So as for now, Ichigo keeps his black and red Getsuga, and I think that's good. That's fine. I'm happy with it. The purple can come later on and I'll be happy with that as well. So if you're a fan of both, you're going to get both regardless at some point. And to kind of top this all off as well, because we haven't really been given too much staff information, what I can say is that the staff so far is better than what we expected. We have some, if you're a fan of the old Bleach anime, you are definitely going to have some old Bleach anime staff on the project, which is really a sigh of relief because they were very passionate about Bleach back in the day. So to see them come back onto the anime is really fantastic as well. As well as Taguchi's influence in having the old Akudama Drive team also involved in the project as well. There is going to be some other animators from other studios, which you may or may not know. I'm not quite sure. I'm not really being told that. It's a surprise, but there's going to be some legendary animators on there as well. So I'm really excited to see who's going to be involved as the months come through, or the episodes. I don't know if they'll announce it as core staff, but again, as episodes come through, I'm really going to be excited to see who's getting involved. But there's a lot of people that are coming from many different series and studios because they want to be involved in some way or the other. So I'm, again, excited to see who's getting involved. But to have the old Bleach staff and also the Akadama Drive staff come together and work on Bleach gives me some really good high hopes on how this is going to be presented and looked. I do have an episode count in mind of what I believe it will be, but because things are always changing with like the success of the anime could happen and we could get light novel stuff, I don't want to say an episode count for it to be used against me later on in the future, but I do think it will go over the year mark for absolute sure, so I'm really excited for that. But I mean, there's not really much more I can say in regards to the Bleach anime as of yet, but I will say that I feel like I needed to do this video because not everyone follows me on Twitter, but if you want to, then there's a link in the description if you want to go, you know, follow my Twitter, of the validity of what I say. And there is a lot of things that I've called in the past, a lot of industry insider stuff as well. So what I'm saying isn't just for clicks or clickbait. I generally say this as a point of either interest or people that are interested. You can either believe me or you cannot, and you can go walk away from it and take it as you will, or you can get really hyped about what I say. But if, again, the industry is always changing, but I want to say that I do have a track record of leaking things. I don't really go out there to tell lies. So if you are on 4chan or Reddit that don't want to give me credit, or you want to say I have no sources, look, there's plenty of screenshots and there's plenty of evidence to suggest otherwise. So, you know, I wouldn't really go out my way to, you know, kind of lie to my audience or Bleach fans in general. I don't see or have any really need to do that. I don't see the point in it. Other than that, I'll try and keep you updated in the most safest way that I can without getting anyone in trouble. But I would say, you know, because we are in a drought with Bleach, I think you guys kind of would like some updates. So, but I will leave it off with that. Create a discussion. Do you think the pacing is way too quick? Do you think it's okay and it's understandable? What do you think your episode count prediction is going to be? And are you mad about your watch's beard staying as bushy as it is? And what do you think about the staff as well? I wouldn't worry too much about Disney at the end of the day. If they get it, they get it. You know, I don't think it's going to be censored. And if it is, then it doesn't really matter because you can just watch it on Japanese TV anyway. You can probably watch the uncensored version on a pirate site, or you can just watch it in the Blu-ray or DVD versions when they come out. So I wouldn't stress really too much about it. But I will say, hit the like, hit the subscribe. I'll try and update you guys on as much news as I can. Tell me what you guys think of these videos. And as always, people, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, Ben Hansen. And as always, people, peace out.